Hi viewers, today I'm going to be talking about the symptoms of a failing map sensor or a bad map sensor, and also how to fix map sensor diagnostic trouble codes P0105, P0106, P0107, all through to P0109. This video is going to cover map sensors as a whole and is not going to be restricted to a particular vehicle make or brand. I'll cover this video in three parts: functions of the map sensor, symptoms of a bad or failing map sensor, and then thirdly, how to troubleshoot for map sensor related codes. Now let's get this. The map sensor is a critical part of the engine emission system and is often left out during tune-up procedures. The function of the map sensor is to measure the pressure in the intake manifold and feed that to the ECM. The ECM uses this to calculate the flow rate of air that is going into the engine. And this is critical because for optimal combustion, you need 14.7 grams of air to 1 gram of fuel. Anytime there's a distortion in this ratio, you'd have drivability issues. If this ratio increases in favor of fuel, it's known as a rich condition, while if it increases in favor of air, is known as a lean condition. So because of this function, you would always notice that the map sensor on this 2003 to 2007 Honda Accord is bolted onto the intake manifold just after the throttle button. It's usually in this same location across vehicles and makes. Some cars feature both a map sensor and a MAF sensor, and as you would see in this 9th generation Honda Accord, it features both a MAF sensor, which is generally before the throttle body, and then a map sensor, which is after the throttle button. Some other cars, especially I've seen a lot of Toyotas that will just have a MAP sensor. The problem with a bad or failing MAP sensor is that it's going to feed incorrect air volumes to the ECM for the purposes of combustion. And because of this, the ECM will erroneously attempt to correct for the impending rich or lean condition by adjusting the volume of fuel to be injected into the combustion chamber. So the symptoms of a failing or bad MAP sensor, and the first can be quite dramatic, which is a no start condition. Here the air fuel ratio is so off that combustion is not able to take place and the car just won't start. Moving on to the second symptom, if the car does start, depending on the degree of distortion of the air fuel ratio, you might have rough idling and misfires. Similar to a no start condition, if the air fuel ratios are so distorted that it's difficult to sustain combustion, then you might have the third symptom, which is stalling. And here, from running rough, the car just stalls. If you're able to keep the car running and drive off, you may experience the next symptom, which is surging. The engine jerks because of the misfires and suboptimal combustion conditions in the engine. The next symptom, lack of power from the vehicle. Usually when you step on the gas pedal, the ECU retains the air fuel mixture slightly to provide more power, but because the ECU doesn't know what volume of air is going into the engine, is unable to provide that input to provide power to the car. All of this is going to lead to poor gas mileage. And the final symptom, if the threshold is met, is the check engine light. And this is where you have one of the several MAP sensor related codes. So the first thing you want to do when you pull out your MAP sensor as you're troubleshooting, and the first thing that could actually give you a MAP sensor code, is poor contacts. So you really want to zoom in and inspect the prongs. You want to look at the prongs here. Make sure that they are not bent, they are not corroded, there isn't deposits on them. Make sure that that's ruled out. Once you're done with that, the next thing you want to look at is the state of the sensor itself. You know, how clean is it? Is it dirty? As part of your troubleshooting, you clean this, spray some MAP sensor cleaner into this hole. Another cause of MAP sensor codes is an open or shot in the MAP sensor harness. One particular cause of this will be rodent activity. Inspect the wires, make sure that the rodents haven't chewed off any part of it. The other thing is the MAP sensor itself could be bad and would need to be replaced. There's a procedure for testing MAP sensors, but in my experience, once you've ruled out these previous ones and go ahead to change the MAP sensor, it usually takes care of the problem. And then lastly, you could also have a bad engine control module and the ECM would need to be changed. This is a very far-fetched and not very common finding, so I would say before you consider all of this, you need to rule out all these other ones, all these other courses before you go ahead to speak about the ECM. So that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching this video. Hope this was helpful. Catch you on the next one. Cheers.